Hey there, this is René for NetworkLessons.com, and in this video you will learn about the different OSPF area types. And here they are. So we got a stub area, there's something called a totally stub, there's a NSSA, which stands for not so stubby area, and there is the totally not so stubby area. So these area types, they sound a bit funky, yeah, but I'll explain what they do, how they work, and then it will make a bit more sense, I think. Yeah. So what we have here is this nice picture, and we got a OSPF network with the backbone area over here in the middle, and we got area 1, 2, 3, and 4. Yeah, and I'll use these areas to demonstrate each area type. Yeah. So let's look at the stub area type first. Let's say that I'm going to turn this area into a stub area. Stub. What does it mean when it's a stub area? Well, it means that we do not allow LSA type 5 anymore within the area. So let me write that down. So no LSA type 5. So that means you have to know what LSA type 5 was about. And LSA type 5, those are all of the external routes. Yeah. So if we had something like, let's say there was a RIP network over here. Yeah. Now when we redistribute those RIP routes into OSPF, then they will show up as external routes. Yeah, and that's LSA type 5. Yeah. When we configure this area as a stub area, then those LSA type 5, the external routes, will no longer be sent into the area. So this one over here, the ABR, it will block LSA type 5. Yeah? It will no longer show up within the stub area. And this means that, of course, the routing table of this router over here will become a bit smaller. Yeah? Okay, so that's the stub area. The second one, the totally stub, let's say we make area 2 over here the totally stub. So totally stub like this. Yeah. The totally stub does two things. First of all, just like the normal stub, no LSA type 5. Yeah. So that's the first thing, but the other thing it does is no LSA type 3. Yeah? And type 3, those are the not the external routes, but the inter-area routes. Yeah? So it blocks external routes and it also blocks all of the inter-area routes. Yeah? So if we make this a totally stub, then this ABR will no longer forward LSA type 5. And it also won't forward LSA type 3 anymore. Yeah? So the only thing you will see on this router here are the OSPF routes from within area 2. Yeah? Okay, so that's the stub and the totally stub. So what are the other two? The not so stubby area. The not so stubby area. Well, if we look at this over here, yeah, I just added this router. And we're doing redistribution into OSPF here. Yeah? But if this would be a stub or a totally stub, they don't allow LSA type 5. Yeah? So basically what I did here is impossible because I'm blocking LSA type 5 within the area. Yeah? So I can't do any redistribution from one routing protocol into OSPF. This would be impossible. Yeah? Now, the NSSA, what it is it exactly the same as the stub. So it will block LSA type 5. But it has something funny. So let's say we turn this area into the NSSA. Yeah? And let's say that we have a router over here running RIP. And we're doing some redistribution into OSPF. Yeah. That will make this guy the ASBR, Autonomous System Border Router. And to make this possible, yeah, we're going to use another LSA type. So the external routes that we redistribute into OSPF, they will show up as LSA type 7. Yeah? So let me write that down. LSA type 7. Yeah? So the external routes, they will show up over here as LSA type 7. Yeah? Those are the external routes. And once they arrive here at the ABR, yeah, so the LSA type 7 external, then the ABR will convert them from type 7 to type 5. Yeah? So the NSSA is exactly the same as the stub area, but by using a new LSA type for the external routes, we can have an ASBR within the area, yeah? Which is not possible with the stub or the totally stub. So let's write that down. So LSA type 7 for external routes. Yeah? So that's a nice trick that we have. Yeah? The totally NSA. So what is the totally NSA? So let's say that this area over here is a totally NSA. NSSA. Yeah. The totally NSSA is the same as the totally stub. Yeah. So no LSA type 3 and 5, but it does do the same trick as the NSSA. Yeah. So it uses a type 7 for external routes. Yeah. Which means that we can turn this router over here into an ASBR. Yeah? So let's say there's an EIGRP router over here. Then this guy can become an ASBR. Yeah? And I didn't add some arrows here, but so over here, we will not allow LSA type 3 and 5 within this area. And also we won't allow LSA type 5 within the NSSA. Yeah? So that's how the different areas work. So let me explain it one more time. This is the backbone area, the stub area. We don't allow LSA type 5 within the stub area. Yeah? The totally stub, we don't allow LSA type 3 and 5 within the totally stub area. And because we block LSA type 5, we can't have an ASBR in the totally stub or in the stub area. The NSSA, it's the same as the stub area, but we use LSA type 7 for externals so that we can have an ASBR within the NSSA area. And we have the totally NSSA, which is the same as the totally stub, so it blocks LSA type 3 and 5. But by using the type 7 LSA, we can have an ASBR within the area. So that's it. So I hope this has been useful. In another video, I'll show you how to configure this so you can actually see how it works on some routers. For now, I hope this has been useful. Thanks for watching and till next time.